I'm Elie Seckbach, reporting.
Okay, the same night. You're going to be at Mars Santa Cruz.
Yeah, we'll be there.
And I think Lipinets is going to sit near you. They already have it. Yeah, they have already set it.
Really?
Yeah.
Lipinets
told me yesterday he wants to fight Broner, and he doesn't mind if it's 140, 144. What do you think?
Well, yeah, I mean, Lippin is a strong dude and big dude, so...
I mean, you fought both of them.
That's a good fight for him. I think he probably actually beats Broner.
Why do you say that?
Because he's very good and he's throwing punches, and Broner really doesn't like to, you know, have that. I mean, if you fighting Broner and you allow him to work, then Broner shines and he grows. But if you keep him on the defense, Broner really doesn't do much.
Same night, another state up the road, Jeff Horn, Terrence Crawford. Does it end in a knockout? Does it go all 12? Does
the
Jeff Horn
same
end?
Night?
Yeah, same night.
June 9th?
Yep.
When are they, where are they fighting?
I think the MGM. The MGM in Vegas. Yeah.
I have no idea. I haven't heard anything. Crawford is bad. I mean, he's going to beat it. Jeff Horn. I think Jeff Horn puts a good fight, but I think Crawford beats him. Crawford is more talented than Jeff Horn. So
does Jeff Horn have any chance? Or is it like Dumb and Dumber, one in a million? There is a chance, but it's really non-existent.
I mean, he has a chance if he can keep relentless pressure on Crawford and just smother him, kind of like what he did to Pacquiao, but give him no space so that Crawford doesn't have space to move around and box and use his height and reach. I mean, he could, but I just don't see. I think Crawford beats him. He's got much more skills.
Now, this week, the WBC, Mauricio Suleiman, said that if Triple G is not fighting Canelo, he needs to fight Charlo. So what do you think of Jermall Charlo, 160, against Triple G?
That's a good fight. I like Jermall a lot. He might be one to beat Triple G. They can try to force Triple G to fight someone, but in the end, if the business isn't right, he doesn't have to take it. He was supposed to fight a mandatory IBF, I think, and they allowed him to take, you know, Ambanez. Really? I mean, Ambanez is not a high elite profile fighter like the other fighters. So, I mean, they can still do it, but I mean, if worst comes to worst, he'll just vacate the title or something. He's got too many titles anyways.
Now, the other big one everybody's talking about, Wilder Joshua. Joshua is with three belts, an Olympian gold medalist. Yeah, Wilder was also a medalist in the Olympics. He had the bronze medal with only 30 fights.
Yeah.
And if he hits you, if he hits anybody.
That's the thing with Wilder. See, before, I think that Joshua would beat Wilder because skills level, I mean, it looks like Anthony Joshua is more polished, more technical fighter, and I would favor him. But recently, I've kind of seen more openings and more opportunities for Wilder to take advantage of fighting Joshua. So one of those punches could definitely drop, you know, Joshua. He's already been down. He shows that he's open just enough to allow a punch to land and hurt him. And if Wilder lands a punch, it could be night, you know, early night. So I think it's a good fight. They can both win it, you know. It's pretty much, you know, an even fight.
Who's going to break Floyd Mayweather's 50-0 record first? You with 38 wins, 38-0, Wilder 40-0. Do you think you could pass Mayweather first, or do you think Wilder will pass him first?
I mean, I'm not shooting for no record. If my goal was just the record, then I'd take on any opponent, any title defense.
And you run through it.
I mean, any title defense that I feel still, you know, they're contenders, they're top 5 contenders, top 10 contenders, whatever, they're title defense. That's what you could do. You could run through all of them. That's not going to do it for me. I'd rather have challenges, big challenges, you know, title fights, unification matches, or move up in weight class, you know, stuff like that. I'm not... chasing a 51-0 record. I'm not chasing that.
Now, Ryan Garcia is 130. You at your gym, you have a lot of 130 fighters. You have Brian Lua. You have Hector Tanahara. You have Jeffy? Who do you think, who do you want to see fight Ryan Garcia first of those three?
None of them right now.
Why?
Let the fight grow. Let it become a big event. If they fight right now, there's not... There's
they
not
fight him, and happening. If they beat him right now, it doesn't mean anything.
It doesn't mean anything.
Let him win a belt or something?
I mean, he needs to, you know, win a world title. They both need to win world... You know, any fighter needs to be a world champion to make it worth something. Right now, they can fight for... I mean, yeah, it's not... I mean, not great money. You know, maybe... $15,000, $20,000, $25,000, you know, maybe $50,000 on a HBO.
But let it grow.
If it grows, it could grow to, you know, a couple $100,000 or even more.
Why does Frank the Cook and why does Bonbon, why did they like Ryan Garcia so much? What is the reason? Is it because it's boxing? Is it because it's YouTube, his Instagram?
I think they like him because he's a funny guy when it comes to his videos, his social media. He's flashy. Not only by the nickname The Flash, but he's flashy with, you know, his videos. He's very confident in his skills, and it creates, you know, just the factor, like the star factor. He's very popular. Frank would probably love to work with him for, you know, marketing purposes. You know.
Speaking of Frank, so last week he sold a bunch of T-shirts, and yeah. I posted a picture with his shirt on, and everybody were asking, did Mikey Garcia give him permission to hustle and stuff? Did you give him permission to make that shirt? Did you authorize it?
I never saw that shirt till that day. I never approved anything, but he kept insisting, and he did it himself. And I told him, all right, then I'm just gonna allow you because you basically just went and did it. But I haven't seen any money from that.
He made a lot of money that day. He was hustling.
He made some money, but that's cool. I mean, that's fine. I just don't. I've told him, just ask me for permission beforehand. Let me approve. Let me see those samples.
Make sure it's not horrible. It's your name, your reputation. Yeah, make sure you didn't put anything offensive on there.
Material. Let me see the pictures. What if I don't like that picture? What if I don't like this material? What if I don't like that cut? Whatever, you know, scheme, graphics, whatever. Let me see it. But I mean, He kind of agreed that he'll be, you know, better when it comes to stuff like that.
Now,
say he'll come Monday.
You signed.
I don't even know why he's coming on Monday.
Is he living here somewhere?
Nah.
Oh, you kicked. He's evicted.
He was staying here. He was here. He was here on Sunday, Monday last week. He said, but then he left on Wednesday. I think he left Wednesday or Tuesday night.
Now, Mikey.
Yeah.
Where are you going, Peter?
I'm gonna meet on Monday. See what time we have to. See what time we have to
find out so I can find out.
Oh, he's fighting.
He's fighting. Luis fighting tonight.
He's fighting yesterday. Who fought? Joshua. How did he do? Did he?
You good? One Franco? Fifth round. In the fifth round, the corner stopped it.
Badass. That's good. And tonight,
Louis
posted. I made weight easy.
He did.
Let
not.
Me ask both you guys.
He made weight.
Let me ask both you guys. If I have to lose 30 pounds, what is the best way for me to lose pounds?
How long do you have?
How long do you have?
Let's say a month. Can I do it?
Yeah,
2 months?
That's tough.
2 months.
You could do it, but it's tough.
2 months is a little bit better. 30 pounds in 2 months.
That's a little bit better.
Yeah, so I don't mind.
How do you do it, Peter? What's the secret of losing weight?
Just eating right. You can work out as much as you want, but if you eat like shit, nothing's going to happen.
So,
you got to eat right.
Diet and water, right?
Look,
water.
Why drink water? What does that do to your diet?
It's fucking healthy. You're not supposed to drink anything else.
In every other country, they drink water. Every other country. But in America, it's soda, it's juice, Dr. Pepper, it's iced tea, everything but water. Red Bulls.
Everybody drinks Red Bull. Wow. My homie Robert Hernandez.
Yeah.
Fucking drink nothing but Red Bulls.
I saw that. He was wired.
Does he?
Yeah, he showed up.
Track?
I told he doesn't need that at the track.
I thought he was taking.
It's even worse.
So if I had to lose weight, what would you recommend me to do right now? Just eat right? What does that mean, eat right?
Like,
I eat right.
No, you don't.
No.
Sleep,
well,
rest?
You eat,
okay, but...
Eat, like, consistently, like, at certain times throughout
times.
The day. Like, get, like,
okay.
a
That's going to be tough. But a routine?
Routine.
Routine.
A schedule.
Get a schedule of how many times you're eating. Eat 4 or 5 times a day. Smaller portions.
And just healthy stuff.
And drink
And no
water.
Sodas, huh?
No sodas, no nothing. That's what fucks me up. I like that.
Steve Nash said he lost, like, 25 pounds when he cut off Mountain Dew.
Really?
So if you cut off soda, he played for the Lakers and he was
a Steve Nash, yeah.
So he lost a lot. So if you get off
played
soda.
With the Suns, the Lakers years don't really count. He played with the Suns.
And he got 2-time MVP when he didn't deserve it. They didn't want to give it to Shaq. Did you watch the playoff game?
No.
Did you watch the finals?
No, I didn't see it.
Okay.
What game
4 seconds left.
What game are you on?
The game two.
Game two is about to go today or tomorrow. Today?
4 seconds left. J.R. Smith grabs the ball, and instead of putting it back up, he runs it out the side of the court. And then they go into overtime, and they
leave. He didn't know what the score was. He thought they were winning. So he got the rebound, and he ran backwards thinking we were winning. We won the game. And then LeBron's yelling at him like,
how the fuck?
LeBron's yelling at him like, what the fuck are you doing? Put it up. He's like, I thought we were ahead. Stupid.
So they did a meme where he's like going to the liquor store to buy Hennessy.
Dang. That would fucked up the game for him. That was just a shot.
It was. They all mad at him. Everybody's mad.
94 World Cup.
Yes, from Colombia, Venezuela. Colombia. The side knocked on the door. And
I seen the documentary, the two Escobars. And he, I guess.
Someone was mad.
He own goal or something. Or didn't stop the goal. I don't know. Something happened.
Okay. I'm going to ask you. I saw this thing, this meme on Instagram. It was pretty funny, Mikey. But you don't need to answer because it's a little touchy subject.
What is it?
Hold on.
Touchy. How's
yes,
touchy?
I'll show you, because someone will be offended. Boxing. Oh, here it is. They asked which fan base. Hold on. I gotta find it. Oh, which fan base has the most annoying fans? And read the six fighters.
Okay, so this is which fighter's fan base is the most annoying. Floyd Mayweather, Anthony Joshua, Canelo Alvarez, Triple G, Wilder, or Lomachenko? Which fan base is the
most? No. How many comments does it have?
564
and
comments.
Look at the answers. All of the above.
Out of 4495 people liked. Okay, so let me see. Comments. Which fan base is the
Every fan base is talking shit with the other fan base.
Well, of course. That's the way it is.
That's boxing.
I mean, if I have to choose, I wouldn't say Anthony Joshua. I don't know. I mean, maybe those Brits out there, maybe they might be annoying, but I don't hear it from them. I haven't seen anything, so I wouldn't say that. I wouldn't say anything about Wilder either. Annoying might be. It might be between Floyd, Triple G, and Canelo. Because with Loma, I mean, yeah, there's some fans that are really, really big fans and talk all this smack, but. Let me see.
Is there anyone missing from that list?
I don't know. Maybe.
So there you have it, another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Elie Seckbach, reporting, and you can follow me on Twitter, at Seckbach. And you can follow me on Instagram, at Elie Seckbach.